Cloud possible? That is one very big question, because when you take an on-premise software, the service provider who gives you the software can customize it as per your requirements. So on cloud, people have this apprehension that is customization actually possible? So what are your views on that, Shreesh?
Customization is one of the biggest things which everybody talks about, but nobody would like to have. Because in the earlier era of SAP or somebody who said that this is there and you should be following this. There is no customization. If you have to want customization, you should pay through your nose, kind of thing. But today, with all the products becoming app-like, you know what I mean by app-like is, it is small software which can do a particular task, rather than the full suite. It all these tasks together form a big the system. What we can do is, instead of going in and starting doing customization for each product, we can choose a suite of features which are available with multiple apps. Get a reliable party to put them all together so that work in as a tandem, and you have a good system. Online system, tracking system, your purchase order system, the sales system, so many things which are there. Like Salesforce has got, they showcase so many things which are there part of this. You can pick and choose and have it what you want, exactly what you want in that. That is why they have built, I noticed that they have built a app developer within that system.
So basically each cloud solution that you take for your organization, they should talk to each other. And it should be at least somewhere linked, or because you can't be using a CRM or a ERP or a HRMS in individually, and they don't talk to each other at all. So how do we, is there such a system where we can actually, get a solution like this?
Yeah, actually, what I mean to tell was, when you talk about customization, basic processes, there are not many variations which you have. Only customization happens in terms of user interface. How, what is it called and how it is done. The user interface part is what normally is customized, rather than the whole process. That is why I was talking about the apps approach rather than the...
Because that is on a daily way. Is there something called private cloud for customization? Are there any organizations, if you are aware of, who use cloud?
My take here is different, in fact. Customization is something which is needed. You can't say, there's no customization, only generic application you should be doing on cloud. The issue is each and every business has a unique requirement. It's not like, you have a generic solution and it will be fitting into. It doesn't work that way. So first of all, few applications are very, very generic, like HR or maybe travel management or even CRM. They are very generic in nature. Take, for example, engineering application, where you have manufacturing happening, you have gauge instrument need to be calibrated. Then you have certain quality parameters, which is very unique and specific to your product or service. And there, you have to segment your application into two parts. One is the generic one, where you can take advantage of cloud and straight off-the-shelf solution. The second is where you have a specific need, business specific need. You can still plug in those custom built riders, and it can be hosted on cloud and it works very well. Because I'll tell you one example where, you know, the company was willing to do extensive quality management on cloud. And they, people from engineering, manufacturing, you know, the gauges and instruments, you know, they need calibration time to time. And it's a very special requirement. And there, the requirement was how to predict, how to simulate and predict that when gauge will be obsolete, it will not be used for verifying a manufactured component. And there, you know, they started using cloud. They started plotting what is the rate of wear and tear of the surface. And then they started predicting when to throw it off. You know, and then they could save a lot of cost in rework, redo, rejection, warranty, etc. You know, so those things are possible. Only thing, one has to segment and customize and host it.
My perspective on customization, everything is customizable. If you look at the solutions which are available in the Indian context, there are large, I would say, players in this space. But why do you need customization is a question. Many times what happens is that having a standard process set up in a large ERPs, whether it is SAP, Oracle, many of them, like it is expected that you adhere to the best standard which is provided by the ERP, which maybe you may not be following that. So maybe that is one, is the one dimension. Second dimension is that there are loads of small ERPs which are available in India. If you look at, there are almost like 25 to 30 small ERPs available. I can take, it is anecdotal, examples like Protostar in Pune, which is actually an ERP which is available. Whether it is Amco, which is available in Indian context, which is a very popular cloud-based ERP. Or whether it, you look at almost like 25 of them are running very well. And these are all cloud-based ERPs allowing you to customize to the extent what you want. So there is a customization also possible. As well as larger ERPs, it is pretty expensive to customize them. So both options are available. As far as possible, because mature ERPs are there, they expect you to adhere to the best practices or standards which are provided in the modules. But you can still customize
it. You can do that. Great. Any specific size of the organization that you should start using cloud? I mean, a startup also, I mean, I run my own startup. So we started using cloud when we were like 10 employees. So as per you, any specific size that an organization should start using cloud?
So my, when we recommend, I think one is people misconstrue always that ERP is always needed. You don't need ERP or cloud is needed only in the context of ERP. Organizations have many functions, whether you look at simple example in with 10 employees example, you could have document, tons of documents getting created. So document management itself could be managed through cloud. So you don't need an ERP, you don't need to reach to an ERP level. So with 10 employees, document management, office communication, whether it is email, whether it is all those kind of functions, you can start using cloud-based solutions which are very, very cheap. There are companies in the Indian context like Vertex, I don't know how many of you have heard of. So it's a non-profit organization, allows you to basically manage your attendance tracking, attendance management, payroll, without charging a hell lot of money to you. Obviously you have to validate whether the solution will fit you or your requirement or not. But to answer your specific question, unless and until you are a small manufacturer where you are looking at core processes or core part of your functionality to be driven by IT, then you start evaluating various ERP systems which are available on the cloud, that too on the cloud, not on premises. And then you decide whether you want to use it or not. So business functionality actually drives whether you want to use it, for what purpose you want to use it. So it is very well possible, and SMEs generally tend to be between 10 to 100 people. So based on your maturity of your business area, you can decide and choose. Various options are available, whether it is ERPs, non-ERPs, enterprise applications, it is available.
In terms of cost for the cloud solution, is there any additional cost beyond the per user, per month cost, which we are not aware of? If you can tell us, what other costs does the organization have to bear beyond that?
In fact, you know, costing part is a bit tricky. You know, let me tell you the basic catch here. Suppose you have taken on cloud, you know, like MSCB, your power supply you have taken. So you consume and then pay. You know, so there they talk about minimum commitment. That is a basic catch today. They say that okay, you are taking compute worth say 10,000 rupees per month. Even if you need 2,000, unless you tell them specifically, they keep charging 10,000. unlike MSCB, you know, the moment you know you don't have consumption, they only charge for your meter rent. You know. So these are the things. Otherwise, you know, things are very, very under control. The finest granule is like, you know, you can take, you know, two core CPU, some memory and disk, and you can start your, you know, application cloud.
So anything, Prasad, on the cost front?
So I would, when we have taken many organizations on cloud, first is you need to do a cost benefit analysis. What we do is generally, you may have manual data today in terms of what is the variation, monthly, the consumption in terms of the disk spaces, in terms of the CPU, whatever you are using today. If you have some amount of measurement available in your organization, then you can decide what option you could go for, which is the cheapest one. Because you can compare today, 5 years back in the Indian context, I'll give you the comparison, bringing cloud, launching on a cloud was very, very complex in terms of security questions were there. Today in the Indian context, there are 4 large operators have their own data centers in India, 2 of them in Pune. So the challenge is not about security, the challenge is not about speed, because you using a small VPN connectivity of maybe 80 kilobytes as a bandwidth, you can connect to a cloud solution or a cloud ERP, which is available. So there is no technological challenges in the context of, or availability challenges in the context of what were there earlier. When you are adopting something in the context of using any solution, which could be attendance management, payroll management, anything, you have to first understand and map for last 6 months data or 1 year data, where you are saying what is my consumption, what is the number of people who are going to use it, what is the demand which is going to be there, and what is the demand for next 3 years or 2 years. On the basis of that, the solution, you can take this demand to the service provider, to the cloud providers. It could be very smallest cloud provider. You will get different quotes in terms of, okay, somebody would say, even I would give an example in today in the Indian context, in the SMEs, there are for 5 manufacturing locations, not 1, 5 manufacturing locations. If you want HCM and other manufacturing modules, maybe 2-3 modules like inventory management, the ERP cost you about between 4 lakhs to 16 lakhs. About 80 to 100 users max. That's the level of pricing which has come down. Now what will happen, there is another provider who can come for your solution and say that, okay, somebody is charging you or offering you 15 lakhs and your variation is not too high from business demand perspective. We will offer at 10 lakh. So there's a lot of competitiveness in the market in terms of pricing. As long as you're aware about your business demand very well, there is no hidden cost beyond that. And it is all inclusive of that. The market is maturing in that context.
Okay. So if an organization actually doesn't use cloud on a very regular basis, I mean, they have an ad hoc requirement of using it once or twice a year, so then would an on-premise solution be better or a cloud solution would be better in terms of cost factor?
My response will be, or my answer to that will be, what is the benefit? If you are keeping it on-premises, are you incurring, let us say example, 25 lakhs example. On-premise, you are managing it with 25 lakhs.
Fixed cost.
As a fixed cost. Or if it is, if you're talking about annually, I'm spending 25 lakh. Then look at options which are available, which will allow you to look at in the context of operating cost being moved to below 25 lakh by maybe 10%, 20%, 30%. Assuming your business demand doesn't change. It should not happen that your business demand is varying and you actually move to cloud with a lower option than 25 lakhs. So you go to basically say 18 lakhs, 17 lakhs, but your business demand pushes you to buy additional capacity at quick speed, then that elasticity is going to cost you more. So the comparison is basically vis-a-vis on-prem or on cloud has to be done in the context of how varying business demand needs are there.